I want to talk to you on the word of God that represents the goodness of God in our life. You see, the word of God is the goodness of God in our life. And I want to talk to you today based on what we should be expecting. What you should be hearing. What you should make of what you are hearing. What you should make of it. Can you hear what I said?
Yes.
What you are hearing and what you should make of what you are hearing. And I tell you the message today, God, our rock, our refuge, and our fortress. God, our rock, our refuge, and our fortress. You know, last week we looked at Acts of Apostles 8, chapter 28, from verse 12. And we saw what happened when Paul and the fellow travelers had a storm. Their ship broke to pieces. Their ship broke to pieces. But God saved them. They landed. They arrived on land. Saved. Without their loads, without their baggages, but they arrived safe. Now let's look at verse 3 of Acts of Apostles in chapter 28. But when Paul had gathered a bundle of sticks and had them on the fire, a viper came out because of the heat and fasting on his hand. Now, I told you last week that whenever there is a storm, thank God, many of us don't come from that area. Some people, they come from an area that is always devastated with storms. Heavy storms, terrible storms. But you know, whenever there is a storm, after the storm ceased, that does not mean there won't be rain. Sun does not appear immediately after a storm. Even when God told Noah that he will not use water to kill the whole world, the whole people in the world. What was the sign that he gave to Noah? It was a rainbow. It was a rainbow. Many of you, I want you to know that the rain that is still falling, or the rain that they are predicting will fall, is not going to be as heavy as the storm that God has taken you through. And if God can take you through that storm, that heavy storm, what is that rain? What is the rain that is going to fall that will now overwhelm you? No way. I come here to tell somebody that just look unto God. Very soon, the sun will start to shine. The rain will stop pouring. Everything will start working well. Do you think it is something I enjoy? Look at every one of us. We are like masquerades. Do you think it is something that we enjoy?
Not really.
It is going to pass over.
Amen.
I said it will pass over.
Amen.
In verse 4, look at verse 4. So when the natives saw the creature hanging from his hand, they said to one another, "No doubt, this man is a murderer, whom though he has escaped the sin, yet justice was not allowed to live." But look at verse 5. But he shook off the creature into the fire, and he suffered no harm. However, can you see? Even after he shook it off into the fire, they were still watching. They were still expecting that his hand would swell, or suddenly that he would fall down dead. But after they had looked for a long time and saw no harm come to him, they now changed their minds and said that this man was a god. You see, many people that are expecting you to fall, you know, during this storm,
yes,
you know, during that storm,
yes,
many people that were expecting,
yes,
that you will be sweating,
yes,
in, you don't know what they are.
Yes.
There are people.
Yes.
There are people. Oh, we know that this person cannot escape it. God disappointed them.
Amen.
You are here today,
yes,
because God disappointed you.
Amen.
Because they proved them wrong.
Amen.
I said that same God.
Amen.
That same God,
Jesus,
is still here today.
Amen.
Whatever rain is still falling,
Jesus,
I said it will not sweep you away.
Amen.
It will not take you away. The ship was destroyed, but they all made it to land. How? Some on boats, pieces of the ship. Some of them, they were hanging on the pieces of the ship. Well, let me tell you, maybe you are here now, and you are still struggling to come to terms with what is going on around you. You hear the news every time, and you are still struggling to come to terms with what is happening around you. Well, I've come here to tell you something. And I want to say to you today that no matter what is happening around you, no matter what name you call it, you have a God.
Amen.
Who is above those things?
Oh, yes.
Who is above the name that thing is named?
Oh, yes.
I want you to know that you are not going to die in it.
Amen.
Your children will not die in it.
Amen.
Your loved ones will not die in it.
Never.
They can be telling you stories that will make you scared, that will make you worried. Maybe the devil has whispered to your ears that you are not going to make it. And the devil is telling you because of this one, because, you know, the devil is very crafty. That maybe because of this, you can see because of people from so area and people dying. You can see because of the age that you are. They can say because of the medication that you are taking, or because of this, because of that. Well, I have come to tell you that you have a God.
Amen.
And that's your God.
Amen.
that you are serving.
Amen.
That your God.
Amen.
That you depend upon.
Amen.
Will see you through.
Amen.
He's still here.
Yes.
I said he's still here.
Oh yes.
I want you to tell the devil something. Tell the devil that, devil,
devil,
I know you are there.
I know you are there.
But I am here.
But I am here.
And I shall make it.
I shall make it.
Through.
Through.
I shall make it.
I shall make it.
Through.
Through.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
They were watching Paul. They wanted to see what we have. They were anticipating your breakdown.
Yes,
they thought you would break down.
Yes,
they were anticipating your defeat.
Yes.
They thought you would be defeated.
Yes.
Well, I have news for you.
Yes.
They will wait for you.
Amen.
I said they will wait for you.
Amen.
Medical science may have told you otherwise. But I have come to give you the good news.
Yes.
They will wait for him.
Amen.
Scientists will be surprised.
Amen.
Doctors will be surprised.
Amen.
God will prove them wrong.
Amen.
I want to tell somebody listening to me today, just keep trusting God.
Amen.
I say just keep trusting God.
Amen.
He will see you safely.
Amen.
They will see you safely through. No matter what anyone is saying,
yes.
I said, just keep trusting
God.
Just keep trusting God.
Amen.
The only evidence that you are going to have, wait for this, wait for it. The only evidence that you are going to have, after all of this, is your testimony.
Yeah.
I said it's going to be your testimony.
Yeah.
That will be your only evidence.
Yeah.
Because you have a God.
Yes.
Look at in Acts of Apostles that we read. When you go back one chapter, in chapter 27. Of Acts of Apostles and verses 18 and 19. Look at it. It says, and because we were exceedingly tempest-tossed, the next day the lightning be shaped. I want you to pay attention to me now. I'm going to you know, these days we have limited time. So this little time that is left now, pay attention very well. He says in verse 18, and because we were exceedingly tempest-tossed, the next day, they lightened the ship. On the third day, we threw the ship's tackle overboard with our own hands. What does it mean to lighten the ship? They threw away what was going to weigh them down. Let me tell you, there is no time that is better than the time for anybody to throw away excess baggage than when that person is going through. Excess baggage. Unwanted, unnecessary load. The time to throw them away is when somebody is in a storm and you want to make it through the storm. You will not care about any other thing. All what you care about is to make it through the storm. When somebody is in a bad storm, the first thing is to throw away anything that can weigh you down. You remember Jonah? When there was a storm, he told them, he said, look, I am the excess baggage here. Throw draw me away and does the sheep will yoke me. Because I am the exit baggage. Noah said it. Jonah said it. And immediately they threw him overboard. There was peace. Very quickly, I want you to know that whatever could make you to live in the spirit of fear, whatever could make you to be a slave to the spirit of fear, you have to throw them out of you. And what is that? It is any sin that you have not confessed. Any sin that you have not confessed. They are the excess baggage that you need to get rid of. If you don't get rid of them, they will weigh you down. They will weigh you down. And once you are weighed down, I can assure you, you may not die, but ask anybody when they are in store. Me, I have never been inside the store, but I remember that, you know, I used to fly so many times. As a matter of fact, I can't count the number of times I have flown. When, you know, when I was still in my country, one day we were coming back, and the pilot told us that in about 15 minutes we were going to enter a turbulence. He said, "But don't worry, it's normal around this time of the year. I will do everything to try to reduce it." Yeah. Yeah. Because I have flown so many times. I have seen, you know, turbulence here and there. But I have never seen this time before. When he started, as a matter of fact, I just made up my mind that maybe no escape for you. Now I started hearing people confessing their sin. Inside the plane. Confession. Serious one that you will never do. The person sitting next to me, I never knew this person before, was holding me like this as if I was the one that was saved. Come and see confession. Because when this turbulence started, one Lebanese man was traveling with me, was sitting on the other side. Ah! That Lebanese man told me that this plane is faulty. I said, "This plane is not faulty." Ah, I said, "You see, all of us are going to crash. This plane is faulty." I said, "No, this plane is not faulty. The pilot told us before that we are going to go to a turbulence. He said, this one is not turbulence. This one is engine problem." I said, "Well, it may be engine problem with you, but not with me." I said, "We are coming out of it." He said, "How?" I said, "We are coming out." And suddenly, I told him, this person that I'm talking about, this man, he came home to greet me. You see, after I said this, then the pilot, I don't know for what reason, maybe the control tower told him he has gone too high. So he came down suddenly, and yes, everybody now started vomiting. They started throwing up. And then we thought that that was the end of it. We moved a little bit. It came down suddenly again. And I was seeing trees and everything. I said, God, they are complete. After that, then the plane settled. And then we moved and I saw that we were just flying by the side of the sea. And that was how we flew calmly till we landed. All the people that confess now, they are looking at themselves, thinking that I hope nobody had this. My Lebanese friend told me that, who are you? I said, I am a child of God. I'm a child of God. And I knew that it's not yet time for me to die. Throw away the excess baggage. They will not help you. And today we have another opportunity. Many people live their life without any need because they refuse to throw away excess baggage. Don't let fear hold you captive. You are reading the news. You are reading the news, watching the news. And you are still hearing about people that die. Maybe some of them should even go. Businesses that are collapsed due to this COVID-19. Let me tell you, the Bible already assured us that we will hear. He said we will even see some of them. He said, but they will not come.
Amen.
That is what you have to believe. You have to believe it. Don't let anything make you to be fearful. If there is any sin in your life that the devil can hold on to, that will make you to become fearful. Today, you can confess it. And everything will be okay.
Amen.
Everything will be okay.
Amen.
The grace of God is sufficient.
Amen.
Maybe you are keeping minds. Maybe, you see, some people, they think sin has category. That once I don't do this, I'm okay. Well, my Bible did not tell me that. Anything that is sin is bad. It makes God to turn away. Because it cannot behold iniquity. So maybe you are keeping malice. Maybe you are bitter about something. And you are holding it on. And you say that person, I will be saying, hello, hello, hello. No more. Why? Because of something that has happened. Today you can confess. And God, you don't need to tell me, it's God you will tell. Not like those people in the play. This is not yet the type of turbulence. You still have time now. Whatever it is, as long as it is a sin, God will not look at it. I don't know. I don't think I have enough time to complete this message. But in Proverbs chapter 9 and in verse 10, the Bible says, the fear of the Lord is what? The beginning of wisdom. It's the beginning of wisdom. And the knowledge of the Holy One is understanding. So, the Lord is the antidote for all your fear. No matter what the fear is. Is it fear of money? Is it fear of death? Is it fear of not having enough to take care of certain things? Is it fear of sickness? Jesus Christ is the antidote for all your fears. It says the beginning, the fear of the Lord is the beginning. So what then is the fear of the Lord? You see, in Exodus chapter 20, when you look at verse 20, the Bible says, and Moses said unto the people, fear not. I want you to look at it. He says, fear not. For God is come to prove you. And that his fear may be before you, that he sent now. Can you see? In that passage, fear was used two times. Can't you see? Did you open your Bible when I was reading?
Yes.
Fear was mentioned two times. That means there are two types of fear. There is the fear of God, and there is the spirit of fear which comes from the head. What is the difference now? They are extremely different. They are what? Extremely different. They have different meaning. The fear of the devil, the one that comes from the devil, the spirit of fear, makes people to be terrified. It makes people to be tormented. When some people dream and they wake up from that dream, they become so fearful, they are tormented because it's from the devil. They will be sweating because it's from the devil. That is the first fear in that place. Then the second one is talking about the fear of the Lord. You see, under the spirit of fear, the fear of the Lord is not intended to bring us into bondage. God has paid the price for our freedom. You know, he paid a very high price. He sacrificed his son so that we can have freedom. He will not now put us back in bondage. No, God will never do that. In the fear of the Lord means that we have to tremble in God's holiness. We have to tremble in his holiness. The Bible tells us that the cherubim that are before the throne, they always cover their eyes because they cannot look at God. Because of the greatness of his glory and because of the grandeur of his majesty. So, sometimes you see some people, Isaiah said that I am a sinner. When he saw just the train of God's majesty, he said, I am a sinner. And this is somebody that before then have been prophesying, have been doing things, great things for God. But when he now saw God, he didn't see God, but he saw him betrayed. He said, I saw the Lord. Because he trained to fill the temple. And the angels were shouting, holy, holy, holy. He said, what a sinner that I am. He saw the difference. You see, that's the difference. I want you to know that God, the fear of God is when you fear His holiness, you fear His glory, you fear His majesty. You will not want to do what He is not happy about. You will not want to do it. God is love. God is love. He is ready himself today to show you love. He is here today to purge you, to wash you clean once again. And you know, in 1 John chapter 4, verse 13, the Bible tells us there is no fear in love. There is no fear in love. He said, but perfect love casts out fear. Perfect love casts out fear. See, fear involves torment. But he who fears has not been made perfect in love. So, ladies and gentlemen, what shall we do? As followers of Christ, we have to wish that we remove every excess baggage from our life. Excess baggage. We have to get rid of it. We have to get rid of them. Because God is prepared to keep us safe. But we have to make sure that we stay under His protection. We must remain under His protection. Today, I want to give you another chance. I want you to stand up wherever you are. I want you to stand up wherever you are. God has made provision for your salvation. The Bible tells us that it's the hand of our salvation. He has made provision for our salvation. And if there is still any stronghold of sin that is holding you down, today you can still talk to God. And God will rescue you. He will wash you clean. Maybe it's that bitterness. Maybe it's unforgiveness. Maybe it's that terrible anger. Whatever. Quarreling. Fighting. Whatever it is. God is here to wash you clean. But you have to tell him. You have to tell him. Say, dear Father, I confess.
I confess.
That I'm a sinner.
That I'm a sinner.
And I am sorry.
And I am sorry.
For all my sins.
For all my sins.
Please forgive me.
Please forgive me.
Clean me.
Clean me.
With the blood of your Son.
With the blood of your Son.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
I believe He came.
I believe He came.
And that He died.
And that He died.
For me.
For me.
And that He rose again the third day.
And that He rose again the third day.
I confess.
I confess.
Jesus Christ,
Jesus Christ,
as my Lord,
as my Lord,
and my Savior,
and my Savior,
both
now,
and forever,
and forever.
Grant me the grace,
grant me the grace,
to live a life,
to live a life,
of holiness,
and righteousness,
from
today,
onward,
onward,
in Jesus' name,
in Jesus' name,
amen.
Amen.
Nothing
can touch me.
unless
they are able
to pass through you.
Because you
are my rock.
You are my
fortress.
You are my refuge.
And I believe
that you are protecting me.
Therefore,
I know
you will not allow
any evil
to touch me
or to touch my family.
Even in times like this.
Oh Lord,
you are my refuge.
You are my hiding place.
And you are my sufficiency. You are the Alpha and the Omega.
You are the one who is,
who was,
and who is to come.
I look unto you
from now on.
Don't worry, they are coming your way. Sit down, relax.